gentlemen. Let's get ready to rumble!
Wake up, Mr. Webb! Web.
Turn down for what?
Gentlemen, welcome to another episode of LeighAlity TV. Y'all already know who it is. It's your boy, Mr. Lee West. I'm right here. My brother, Brian Katea.
What's going on?
My brother, it's Wednesday. It's 9 p.m. It's StrongLand.TV. You're in the right place. Wind up Wednesdays. Right?
Isn't it supposed to be down?
What do you up? Want? Let's do uppers.
Wind
up Wednesday.
A lot of people prefer downers for some reason.
Yeah,
wind
yeah,
down.
Those.
You know, a lot of depressed people. Like, I guess they might be like goth emo. Like,
you know
I just
what it is?
Wind down.
You know what it is nowadays, bro? I noticed that the drug addicts now, they're useless, bro.
Oh yeah.
Useless.
But they were very productive back in the day.
Back in the day, you give a crackhead $5, all your leaves are gone, your car's washed. You don't let them do any inside stuff. But you know, you can wash the outside of the house, whatever it is, man. The top windows, whatever you gotta do.
Do you know all this from experience?
Well, not use it. You know, I pay them.
I mean, you kind of fit the picture sometimes.
Of a kraken?
Of a kraken. You kind of look like
I sleep way too much for a kraken.
You look at your eye. Like, just like, even looking at the camera, your eyes look like they're, like, bugged out. You know, like.
Wow.
Like, you're wearing sunglasses. Like, that's typical. Like, if your eyes are all, like, fucked up and you want to cover your eyes so you don't look like you're a drug addict, so you just put down the shades.
Weed's not a drug, man.
That's true. I mean, it is a drug. What the fuck is that? I guess it's not on the list of drugs.
My wrists are naked. I forgot my wrist bling.
Your wrist bling? I got a wrist bling.
Nice little wrist bling you got going on there, my man.
Girlfriend bought me some wrist bling.
Gotta have sugar mama. Gotta have sugar mama.
First time I'm wearing a wrist bling. My arms used to be just bare and naked. It's like this, like that.
Bare naked.
Bare naked, look,
you're such an idiot.
I am such an idiot.
So, last week, we celebrated the 1 year anniversary of us doing LeighAlity together, the 2 year anniversary of LeighAlity in a total. That's like, wait, 52,
weeks
that's 104 days a week LA gets to deal with me. I mean, 104 days a week. 104 days so far.
Every 2 years.
Yeah. 104 days. LA
104 days a week.
104 days an hour. 104 days a day. It's like it feels like 104 days every time you
That's
eat.
Like 300. That's like 450 Wait. Days in a week.
Hang on, go show them over there. This week in the studio we have with us. Hang on, can you show them? Over there, can you, this week in the studio we have with us, the music manager and film manager, Brad Busy, is in the building with us, and he brought along the pop artist, EDM artist, Chris Casino. Give you guys subs a what up, gentlemen?
What's up? What's going on?
They're gonna be sitting with us in a little bit.
This is how you know, is how you know Lee West.
What?
Casino.
Yeah.
C-A-S-E-N-O. Not even this.
And? What's the problem?
You need to work on your spelling, my friend.
I'm not spelling for you. You crackhead.
Crackhead, you should just be mowing people's lawns.
Fuck that. I did. When I was a little kid, I had a lawn... service. I did the whole neighbor's block. I called it Love Your Lawn Time.
That's pretty good time.
Love Your Lawn Time.
I kind of like that. So here you are telling. So did you just hire a bunch of crackheads all the time? Or like.
Yeah!
To your company? Just surround yourself with a bunch of crackheads?
No. Like, you know, you have like one guy just, you know, because they don't. You know, they come up, hey, you got something I could do for like $5? You know, yeah, go take the garbage pails out, man. You know, like, whatever.
People are just knocking on residential homes, like, scratching themselves.
You know, like at the shop and stuff. You know, they come around and say, yo, you got a cigarette, man? You know, like, whatever. Like, whatever.
C-A-S-E-N-O, everybody.
Casino. Well, how's it spelled?
C-A-S-I-N-O.
Oh, so I got one vowel mixed up.
Well, it looks like a G. C-A-G-E-N-O, it looks like Cajino. I'm giving you the benefit that that's an S.
That's supposed to be an S. Kind of like a sideways five.
Yeah.
What'd you do last weekend, butthead?
I'm looking at houses.
You looking at houses?
Yeah.
I see houses all the time. I drive past a ton.
I have an accepted offer on a house.
Yes.
That's what I've been focused on. That's why I feel like I'm at, like, so far, like...
You're not even in the planet right now.
I'm not even in the planet right now. Normally I'm funny and, like, I'm not. Like, I'm just... You're fucking asshole. But me and my girlfriend, we're looking at a house around Conkma.
Mm-hmm.
225. We got an accepted offer. I'm stoked about it. I'm getting an engineer to look at it. And
congratulations,
pumped,
my brother.
And hopefully we, you know, we're going to have a house in a few months.
That's good, man. You've been working at that for a long time. And I'm guys.
January.
That's awesome. Super, super duper awesome.
And what was your weekend like? What did you do, Mr. Lee West? LeSean?
My weekend was a little bananas, man. So, me and the girlfriend, we went over to Fire Island, and it was getting late in the day. It was like 4 o'clock on a Saturday. I'm like, whatever, let me just take the Sayville Ferry, and I'll just go to Fire Island. And like, how bad can it be? How bad can it be? Is all I'm saying. Like,
Sayville
Ferry? Like, all
right.
Yeah, you know, I know it's the gay part or whatever, and I'm just like, how bad could it really be? I've hung out with gay dudes before. It's like not a huge thing, you know?
I know, we see LA 104 times a week.
And, It was off-putting, to say the least. I mean, I was eyeball-effed like 100 times over.
Okay.
Which happens. I'm a sexy motherfucker. I could deal with it. You know what I mean? When one guy asked my girlfriend if he could rent me, is when I had like a little like, whoa, put me on a water taxi, get me to Flynn's, man. I'm out of here, man. I wanted to go to Flynn's. I'm gone, man. And it was everybody was really nice, but
this is the difference
culturing.
Between
I was
me
cultured.
And Lee.
I was cultured.
I try to buy a house, and he goes and hangs out with gay people.
I got nothing wrong with the gay
There's
people.
Nothing wrong with gays. I said that kind of derogatory. I didn't mean to. I apologize. The very PC America that we have now.
Fuck PC America.
Okay, you see America. That's he was hanging
about.
Out with a bunch of gays. That wanted
I was
to
hanging
fuck
out with the gays, and everybody wanted to do me. I don't blame them for wanting to do me. I've seen me.
I blame them. Who want to fucking do you? Look at you.
Look at me. Exactly.
Yeah, fucking...
I'm a sexy motherfucker.
Can I say something?
Long time. Of course you can say something.
I don't know. Something tells me that if a gay guy wants to get with you, it looks like he wants some like rough sex or something like that. You know what I'm saying?
Well, anybody that wants to fuck me wants rough sex. Yeah, there's no way you're going to go around.
There's something about you and sex. It's just a little scary.
LA the engineer.
I'm sure you have your soft side, but...
Oh, yeah.
Well, now we have the...
But at first glance.
Now we know that the producer of the show has imagined having sex. Who with Lee West.
I'm the producer. He's the engineer.
The engineer, whatever. The sound guy.
The sound guy. The owner of this thing we do here. Mr. Strong Island himself.
Can you diminish my title anymore?
Yeah, he's just here. He hangs out.
The guy, he presses buttons. Love you. All right. So at 10 after every Wednesday, we do this segment we like to call Comic
Con. No, continue. You went to Flynn's.
I don't think I should tell that. All
right. No, but I also have something else that happened funny. I went to an open mic last night.
Did you?
I went to an open mic at Bartini Bar.
Shout out Bartini.
Shout out to Bartini Bar in Babylon, right? So there's this comic, I'm not going to name names, but his name rhymes with Pevin Mice.
I'm glad you didn't actually say that name on the show, because we don't say that name on the show. There's one rule, and it's don't say that.
All right, so this guy has started comedy for as long as I've been doing. Like, he's been doing it for at least 30-plus years. So he goes to this open mic, and he's... You know, he kind of like just in his own world all the time. He bought a car, this guy.
The lamest basement is living dad, rent paying person that we know. Gone.
So now he goes, it's so funny, because like he's coming up to me, he's bragging, he goes, look, I got this car. I spent, it was only $2,000. I'm like, yeah? I'm like, how many miles on it? He's like, 60,000. I'm like, wow, 60,000, that's actually not a bad deal. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, what year is the car? He's like, 2004. I'm like, all right. So I'm looking around, the car is like a little beat up on the sides and everything. And then I'm like, is there any noises? Do you hear anything? He goes, oh, well, you know, when I shut it off, it goes, ting, 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 ting. I'm like, I'm like, that's not good. That's not good, Pevin.
Pevin.
I'm like, did you get this car looked at by a mechanic? Oh, and he's like, oh, no. I was supposed to do that? I fucked up. Meanwhile, this guy's like borderline, like he's probably like 45 at least. And he's just a fucking... And I, like, I've been doing comedy since I was 17. And I'm 28. And like, since I started, I've went to college, paid it off. Now I'm like in the process of trying to buy a house. And he comes up to me, look at my car, it's $2,000.
I spent $2,000 on it. All right, I don't even want to talk about that guy.
I don't know. I thought it'd be right. Funnier.
I thought it'd be funnier. All right, so last week we talked about the gorilla. The gorilla was hilarious. We did the top five gorilla memes.
Yeah, we did.
And after we did the show, about a day or so later, I found the number one hilarious gorilla meme. Ally, can we show the funniest gorilla meme ever in the world? And just like that, a gorilla shut everybody up about the bathrooms.
Yeah, nobody even talks about people, the transgender bathrooms anymore.
That's gone. That's like the dress. Like, we don't talk about it anymore.
Yeah, the gold and blue dress.
It's old news. Yeah, it was blue and gold, just like my high school. All right, I will come back over here. All right, so at 10 after on Wednesdays, what we do is a segment called Comedy Corner. It's where we try out new material and work on our old material and hammer out some jokes and do some stuff. So the next time you see me, I'm going to stand over there. But we don't have anything to cut to, so just see me over there.
Did we check it? Is it checked? Oh, it's checked. Hey, what's up, guys? See, I told you next time you see me, I'll be over here. I'm Mr. Lee West. I like to try to tell jokes once in a while, and it's fun for me and probably not so much for you. Working on a new joke, everybody. In the last couple weeks, you guys might have seen me working on this new joke. But we'll try it out, right? So I was just chilling one day, right? I was all chilling, and I was being nonchalant, right? I was just all chilling, being nonchalant. Came to think, like, what would it be like if I was to be... Shallant. Would it be like all up in somebody's face? You know? Super shallant? Re-shallant? No, you guys really don't want me to do that again, do you? Then I'm like, you know, maybe I'm over here getting like a little overzealous. Let me just dial it back down to just zealous. You know? And then so I figured that type of joke is like really unorthodoxed. Is anybody out there doing like orthodoxed type of stuff? Aside from what is the religion that has orthodox in it?
Greek Orthodox.
Oh, the Greek Orthodox. I don't know any jokes about that. Greek Alexander the Great. That's Greek stuff. That's as far as I get with the Greek. What was that hot chick? Aphrodite. Oh, I'll work Aphrodite into that somehow. Orthodox. So think about stuff too. Anybody got any more compound words that the root word isn't a real word? Send them over, and I'll try to make it funny. So, with further ado, I'd like to introduce to you guys my brother, my pro-host on the show, Project Nine Lines. Mr. Bright, I'm talking really slow because he's taking a long time. Bright, get there!
What's going on, America?
America.
So now I'm green today. Last week I was blue.
Look at that
green background. It's like the fucking Brady Bunch. So I'm getting fat, and
don't know about you guys, but whenever I try to lose weight, I always try to like motivate myself. Do you ever do this? Do you ever take these before pictures? You ever take these pictures? You're like, you know what? I'm going to show everybody. I'm going to prove to you guys I'm going to lose this weight. Now, have you ever went back a few months, took a look at a before picture? Like, holy shit, I looked good, you know? See, my problem is I like to eat, you know? I go to all these restaurants. And my pet peeve at restaurants is I hate when waiters and waitresses, they try to memorize your order. You know, because they're always cocky about it. You know, they always come up to you with, like, their hands behind their back. Like it's a magic act. They're like, how do you want your steak? Rare? Got it! Like, how do you want your fries? Waffle? Got it! Like, go play Daredevil with somebody else's order. Don't put mine in jeopardy. Now, like, here I am on a nice day, and all I can think of is, holy shit, I hope they remember the waffle fries. You know, and then I go to these restaurants. You ever go to these nice, fancy restaurants? You know, like shirt and tie and everything. And they never give you a napkin. No, they always give you this cloth towel that you're supposed to just lay over your crotch. And nothing else to wipe your mouth. So, like, mid-meal, you're just, like, bending over. It looks like you're trying to give yourself oral mid-meal. And nothing else to wipe your mouth. You know, and they just give you this crotch towel. And that's it. And I really think they chose the wrong demographic of people. Like, who really goes to these fancy restaurants and gets barbecue sauce all over their suit and tie? This doesn't happen. No, but if I was at an ale wing house or some shit, they give you these little frumpy napkins that don't even work.
Oh, those suck, man.
Fucking horrible napkins. I wish I had a crotch towel in those situations, but no, I don't. But sometimes you see people that are too skinny. Do you ever see that? Ever see, like, people that are like, oh, this person's anorexic, they're bulimic, way too skinny. And the first food of choice that they always offer these people, you know, she should eat a cheeseburger. Like, a cheeseburger. When did that become the ultimate weight gain food? Like, granted I'm fat, but that's, like, my Tuesday, you know? Like, a cheeseburger. Like, I could tell you how to gain weight, you know? And it's not just a cheeseburger. It's like Domino's, 3 a.m.
Yes!
Cheesy bread, all the sauces.
Every sauce.
You know, if a cheeseburger makes me fat, Jesus Christ. I could give you advice. I could give you advice on how to gain weight. A cheeseburger, you'll be stable. Oh, man. But I bought my girlfriend a Fitbit. A couple of months ago. And don't ever do this, because I don't know if you know this, but these Fitbits, they track your sleeping patterns. So, like, now she has an excuse to, like, yell at me. She goes, oh, look, you aggravate me. I can't even get sleep. Look, here's proof. I'm just like, Jesus Christ, the worst investment you could possibly give. And everybody was making a big mess before this gorilla thing about these transgender bathrooms. Like, who the fuck cares? Like, who really cares? I've never really cared that much about the person taking a piss next to me. Like, am I going to look down? Holy shit! Where's your cock? Like, no. I really don't give a fuck. Like, do what you want. Your peeing has no effect on me peeing. If there was ever a time that somebody peeing that had an effect on me peeing, like, all right, there's... If you're peeing on me, in my general, like, you know, just above me somehow, like, golden showering me, okay, there's an issue.
Am I getting splashed?
Am I getting splashed on? Man, you ever shit so hard that you gave yourself a headache? All right, that was it. That was my entire joke. You never done that?
I've relieved headaches.
Then, like, you have to take an Advil. Like,
would you get an aneurysm?
Man, you ever hear, you know you're in the ghetto? Have you ever noticed you're in the ghetto? When you see an ice cream truck pull up that, like, used to be an ambulance? Like, holy shit, what kind of ice cream am I getting from this truck? Man, and then have you ever noticed when somebody gets a haircut? I'll go into the whole haircut bit, actually. I'll do the whole haircut bit. You know, every time
I get a haircut. It's always awkward, the entire haircut. You know, first off, they sit you down. You know, they throw on that backwards cape. You know, you look like a dyslexic superhero. You know, and out of nowhere, they'll just start talking to you, you know. You know, it's like an awkward date. They're just like, how was your day? Just fucking, you know. What do you do for a living? Now, do you like long walks on the beach? Like, fucking cut my hair. And you can tell these barbers, you know, they're really hurting for money. Because out of nowhere, they'll just slap shaving cream on your face. Like, now you have to give an extra tip, you know. They start doing your eyebrows, giving you a massage. They're blowing you by the end of the haircut. Like, I made of money. So it's the last time I let my mother cut my hair. I swear. But, you know, when somebody gets a haircut, you know, even if the haircut sucks, there's no way to address it. Now, every time somebody gets a haircut, you always have to say, oh, nice haircut. You know, but, like, what happens if it sucks and it's a noticeable haircut? You just say, oh, there's hair.
It's different.
You did something different. Well, like we said, this is Comedy Corner, where we work on new material. Thank you. Thank you for listening. Frank Taylor, German Project 99.org.
All right. We got our guests. We're gonna show their video. But right, you said something about the ice cream man in the ghetto. I've never seen the ambulance ice cream man in the ghetto. I haven't seen that one. But since I was a little kid, I had the same Mr. Softy coming down my parents' block, singing that awesome, delicious song, num 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 yum yum yum. Right, Joe. Every day, hey Mr. Softy, is it Kaylee? How's school? I'm like, yeah. You know, years later. I'm like, hey, Mr. Softy, he's like, hey, Lee, how's business? I was like, yeah. Years later, I'm like, hey, Mr. Softy, he's like, hey, Lee, how's comedy? Yeah. It was just last August. I was over at my parents' house visiting with my pops. Mr. Softy come on down the block. He's an old man now. I'm like, hey, Mr. Softy. He's like, Lee, my name's Dave. Can you call me Dave? Whatever, man, you feed me ice cream, I'll call you any damn thing you want me to call you. He's like, you know, I was with the old lady the other night having a little trouble rising to the occasion, and all I could think about was you calling me Mr. Softy. That's my ice cream joke. All right. So, with some more ado, we got these awesome dude. We got your trailer for your movie. What is it called again one more time? Respect the Come Up, of course. So we have the trailer for the web series Respect the Come Up. Enjoy that. When we come back, we'll have these fine gentlemen sitting on a couch with us, and you know, maybe we'll stuff some wine down their gullet. Check them out. To come up, ladies and gentlemen. Cool, man.
That's pretty cool. All
right. What's up, Chris?
What's up,
there you go, man.
What's up?
Welcome to the studio, gentlemen. Welcome.
Yeah. What's up?
So, there may be a few people at home that may not know exactly who you guys are. So if you take a moment, take a look at the camera, tell people who you are, where you're from, what do you do?
Yo, what up? I'm Chris Cassino, the international pop artist. I've been around the world.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Brad?
Brad Busy. Filmmaker, music manager, you know, tour manager, managing the hottest independent EDM pop artist, Chris Cassino.
What's up?
That's awesome. What I do, you know?
Very awesome. I like that you also rock some shades. You know, we do sunglasses on the inside.
They're good. Tom Ford's.
All right. I got some Snap-on joints.
It's called 2020.
No hiding, nothing. He don't brush his hair anyways.
Yeah, I don't even do shit.
So where do you guys reside from? I see you coming out from out west a little bit, Brooklyn. Where are you guys originally from?
I'm from Brooklyn.
You're from Brooklyn? Chris?
Yeah, I'm originally from Brooklyn, Flatbush.
That's cool.
Absolutely.
That's cool. And you guys are out there now still, or?
No. We out the hood now. Only time I'm in the hood is when we're in the hood.
Awesome. How long have you been in the EDM pop?
I'm pretty new to it. You know, I've probably been recording EDM pop music for like 2 years.
Okay.
And
you got the look like you've been like, doing it.
I've been in the hip hop world. I used to do a lot of hip hop. I'm still, you know,
okay.
Hands in here and there. But, you know, switch my sound to a more broader sound.
Yeah, you gotta go.
I wanted to do something that could bring me to all different parts of the world. So I said, let me try.
EDM will do it, man. And
plus, you know, I'm talented enough to do it. So
God bless that, man. Yeah. For sure.
So have you been to like all these festivals and stuff?
All of the festivals. I just came off a tour. I just finished doing Spring Break down in South Padre and the Rodeo down in Texas and, you know, South by Southwest.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all the major pop festivals.
That's pretty cool.
And what do you do when you get there? You performing out there? You spinning?
Yeah, of course. You know, we got 35-minute sets. We're on stage for 35 minutes.
35 minutes, nice.
Performing, you know, 10 of my records and, you know, getting a great response.
Excellent.
So it's been good.
Excellent.
Yeah, I heard a lot about, like, Tomorrowland and Electric Forest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. With the real shit with you.
No, you can say whatever you want. We got the sticker up.
Yeah, you can say.
you can say whatever you want. We got the sticker up.
Yeah,
fuck the world.
Yeah,
that's cool, man. So, when you were in hip hop, like, when did you make a conscious decision to devote your life to entertainment?
I've always been entertaining, man.
I popped out, man.
Yeah. Since I love music. You know, I had an older brother. He was into hip hop. I saw him do it. You know, I was. And still, you know, am a big fan of the culture.
Awesome.
You know, and you know.
You live off of music or you have a day job?
100, nah, no day job.
Awesome.
I live off of music.
Ladies and gentlemen, this right here is, man, living the dream.
I probably sold 100,000 CDs on my own, you know what I mean? If you're watching out there, they know I'm not playing.
So even at a dollar a piece, you're doing okay.
If I'm going to tell you guys something crazy.
Tell us something crazy.
I've gotten $100 for a CD for 1 hour.
Wow.
$100.
Wow.
One time or all
time.
The albums
no,
sold
one
for?
Time. One time.
What, did he just threw it after? I mean, like, you didn't sell it for him.
I'm a hustler, so
wow.
You know, we know how to talk.
Yeah, that's it's awesome. Worth $8 million. I'm giving it to you for $100. It's a deal, bro.
That's awesome.
I get it, man. That's what's up.
Yeah. That's so, like, when did you, like, first start to get success? At what age, like, were you?
When I first started to get success was the first time I decided to push my CD out in 2000. I decided to put out.
Wow.
Yeah, I had a good friend of mine. He passed. His name is Greg Riles. And he always said, Chris, you know, I know you hot. When you gonna let everybody else know it, man? Don't get stuck in demo hell. I was like, you know what? All right, I got you. I got in the street, started selling my CDs, started making money. I was like,
awesome.
You know what? This is it. This is my road to success right here.
Excellent.
You know?
Wow. That's awesome. So, like, you did hip-hop and everything, so you used to go to all these things?
I used to go to all the hip-hop events, all of that, man. You know, I just wanted to do something that could bring me to different parts of the world, man. You know, I wanted to see what Belgium was like, what France was like.
That's
and
awesome.
Then throughout my travels, I started seeing how big music was, and I started seeing that, you know, hip-hop only covered a certain area.
Yeah.
Right.
I said, you know what? I need to be in that pool of
broaden your horizon.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Awesome.
That's pretty cool.
Oh, we don't, I wish I had a track.
I thought I said the beautiful girl. I'll send it.
If you have it on your phone, we can plug it in. But, that's really cool, man. What was your favorite, event to perform at, this past season?
Spring Break.
Where were you exactly? That was
we
best.
Was at Clayton's. We was at Louis.
Yeah, if you give it to LA, can you plug this in so we can hear one of his jokes?
He's gotta bring it over.
Yeah, he'll bring it over. Go ahead.
Yeah, we was at Lou's backyard. Spring Break was a real great experience because, you know, we had all the college kids and
college kids goes crazy, man.
That's where the dude girls going wild at.
So. Yeah.
Well, yeah. It was a zoom.
Where are,
was
you this? Are you married?
South Padre. Am I married? Nah.
How many white girls did you bang? She didn't laugh because they know. I like. He's like, I don't know that number. He's like, you know, I'm out of, you know.
I don't know who's watching this, man.
None. There was no.
Zero.
Only black chicks. No white girls. So I'm a dude of a crazy haircut. Tell me what do you got going on there? Did you just like get pissed off in the middle of a haircut and leave?
Yeah, you know.
Or
you know what? I thought I was doing something different. So
it's definitely different. I'm doing something different too.
My barber, man, he's dope, man. He's like, yo, you know what? We're gonna fucking leave this piece right here.
Can you show the camera? Show the people, because I don't think people can see.
Yeah, they're not getting it right now. Yeah. It's there.
It's like the back of the head is.
It's almost like a shag, man. It's almost like a cool shag, man. Don't bite my haircut.
No, yeah, that's called the Chris Casino. This is called the Lee West.
Tell us what you like about the kids seeing you.
Oh, no, like sometimes there'll be like little kids in the barbershop or whatever, you know, and they're looking at me like all kind of crazy with, you know, the shaved sides and then and the beard and everything. And they're looking at me like, oh. Like you're like a puppy with a biscuit, you know? I'm like, oh, you like my haircut? And they're like, yeah, because they don't really, but they don't know what else to say. You know, oh, tell your mom you want the Lee West.
But I think the Lee West has been around, man.
Yeah, it was. I saw somebody with it, and I was like, that's the haircut I'm going to get, you know?
So it
like,
fits you.
Thank you. Yeah, I couldn't imagine myself with a different haircut.
Do you see this haircut? This is called Woke Up.
It's called the unkempt frat unkempt. Boy.
I haven't done shit. I mean, like at the back, it's like a rat's nest back there. It's fucking.
Are you guys? You guys are ready with the joint?
Yeah. All
right. I guess cut us to a flyer, and we'll play Chris Casino's.
Let's get into this beautiful girl single, man. This is gonna be the number one record in the country.
CAS,
yeah. All I know is I ain't ever felt like this before. Gotta give these girls a little competition for sure. The baddest girls all over the world, and I had my share.
When I met you, I knew, girl, you were the one for me. You make my palms so sweaty, make my heart skip a beat. I think I found the girl that I've been waiting on so long. Soon as our eyes met, knew them other girls was wrong. She grabbed my hand and led me right to the floor. She did some things that I never seen before. She dropped it low, then twerked it up some more. I threw my dough until I had no more. Until I had no more.
I'm so in love with such a beautiful girl. I'm so in love with such a beautiful girl. I'm so in love with such a beautiful girl. Beautiful girl. Beautiful girl.
When I'm away from you, I'm not. If your love was a cell, girl, you had my heart on lock. He don't understand you, girl, like I understand you, girl. I'm your man and you're my girl. Let's take trips around the world. You could go wherever I go. How about flights out the Cabo? When I take you to the bar, girl, and I buy y'all a drink. Dropped it low, then twerked it up some more. I threw my dough until I had no, till I had no more.
I'm so in love with such a beautiful girl. Beautiful girl. Beautiful girl. For sure, the baddest girls all over the world, and I had my share. But this one right here, man, this one right here, right here.
seen before.
This one right here.
Never seen before.
This one right here.
Never seen before.
This one right here. I'm so in love with such a beautiful girl.
He's going back for a song.
Yeah.
Bro, that was awesome.
That was so
I could rock with that.
Appreciate the love.
For days.
That was awesome.
And that was you on the track?
Absolutely. I could see that on the radio, like right now. Like,
yeah, that's like a BLI joint, like for sure.
That's like top quality sound, everything. Like I'm astonished.
Come in a little more, man.
Appreciate
there you go.
Yeah. You know, that's
appreciate
awesome.
That. Yeah, man. How long did that project take to put together?
Well, we worked on that record probably for about 2 weeks.
Wow.
2 weeks. You hear people in the lab for months.
Yeah.
I can't even make a joke.
Well,
no,
we put records out like this, you know, second nature.
The turnover, the turnover time in anything, whatever kind of business it may be, and music being one of them, the turnover time is a huge part.
No, we deliver. We deliver.
Like UPS, man.
Right, no, we totally deliver.
That's great.
So, Brad.
Yeah.
That was an awesome movie clip thing. Like,
oh, yeah, yeah.
For
your web series. Thanks, yeah. So, web series I worked on, you know, working on different projects for other people, I decided, you know what, I wanted to do something, you know, on my own. It was a little difficult in the beginning because, you know, it's hard kind of getting a crew together, you know, when there's, like, you know, no budget, basically.
Right. Yeah.
But so we put it together and we actually releasing episode number 8 next Monday.
So this is a TV series.
Right. It's
episode.
Currently on YouTube. You can YouTube Respect the Come Up and you'll find it. It's under a YouTube channel called Street Cinema, Street Cinema is my boy Tony out in Detroit. It's a company that's dedicated to distributing like independent urban content.
And we should hook him up with H.
Yeah, yeah.
Potent TV. We went to a movie premiere for.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
What was that? What was the name of the movie?
Rush. Yeah. You've seen Rush?
I heard of Potent TV though, but I haven't seen Rush.
Yeah.
It was pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah, it was cool. Yeah, we had fun in the movie.
They rented a movie theater, and it was like their first showing of everything, and like the movie theater was packed.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it was really cool.
Nice. And, you know, Chris Cassino is also in Respect to Come
That's
Up.
Right,
you know,
right,
I try to, you know, me being a filmmaker and him, me working with Chris, I try to put him in whatever I'm working
with. Yeah, absolutely. That's what we, you know, we are separate entities, but at the same time, we try to put each other in as much as we're doing together.
Mm-hmm.
That's a really cool thing, man.
So do you record the entire thing all at once and then put it out, like...
Well, how long are your episodes?
Yeah, the episodes are short. They range from 7 to 15 minutes.
That's the best way
to do it. The reason why I did it like that is because, you know, I figure on YouTube there's a lot of stuff, so it's like, you know, it's very difficult to grab people's attention. So I wanted to give something quick and to the point.
Yeah.
You know, as opposed to, you know, if I was working on something on television, it would be the standard... 23 or 45 minutes.
Right.
So with the Respect to Come Up, we kind of just filmed did the whole season and then released it. Season 2, we actually do have a crew now and
awesome.
People that want to be a part of it. So we're going to do it the traditional way and, you know, shoot episode by episode. You know, so.
Excellent.
Look out for season 2 in September.
Look out for season 2, y'all.
So. If you could explain to the audience, I know they saw the trailer, but what exactly is this web series about?
Respect to Come Up is a web series. It's about basically young adults who in the inner cities who decide to come up, which is a slang term for, you know, basically change their financial position from rags to riches. Season one, we kind of focused on illegal activity, you know, primarily credit card fraud, which is very popular.
Right, that's what we saw in the trailer. Yeah.
But in season two, what we're going to do is we're going to take a more a legal approach and talk about people who are starting their own sneaker stores, right, their own businesses. You know, basically whatever they're doing to come up, we're going to kind of put it in a series.
That's dope. That's dope.
Absolutely. Yes. And I mean, whatever. But, I mean, how much dirty money has actually started legitimate business?
Exactly. Yeah.
In the world. And, I mean, that's where a lot of people...
This country was built on dirty money. So.
Yeah.
It's still running on dirty money.
Yeah, it's still running, right.
Yeah.
Right.
But, I mean, a small independent business, I was one myself, you know? And, right. And it you yeah, need...
I love you a long time.
I love you long time. You know, right. I stole my father's lawnmower. Right.
That was weed money.
Right. It was. I was weed whacking.
I hope the statutes is over with that.
Yeah. No, off the grid. I already got charged for it. It doesn't matter. I can talk all you want.
Okay. Yeah.
But
yeah, to your point, you know, a lot of, you know, when you look at Kennedy's and, you know, a lot of legitimate businesses started out underground, you know,
yeah.
So that's why the first season we wanted to focus on underground.
Right, make it realistic. Yeah. You know, nobody's just, you know, yeah, there's trust fund kids that have money to invest in stuff, but none of us are them.
Right.
You know,
so,
like.
Right. So obviously this isn't a documentary series. This is all just, you know, right, all stories. So do you have a perspective in your own mind of, like, the end of the series? Do you know how, like...
Well,
Who has to die?
Well, there's a few deaths in it, but, basically what we talk about the underground, economy, and we, you know, we highlight the people being successful, but we also highlight the dark side of it. You know, there's people... Like in the season finale, who go to jail?
Mm-hmm.
There's people who get killed. So you know, we try to give both sides because you know, at the end of the day, we don't want to come across like we're promoting. We also planning on doing a documentary series. You know, about it because documentaries is really my real passion. To do because I'm very big on you know, entertaining as well as educating the consumer.
Absolutely.
As well. You know.
So let me ask you personally, because I'm part of I'm doing a book writing workshop, mm-hmm. book writing and publishing workshop, and I started to write this book, and it's based on a true story, but I'm making it fiction. But I was never sure if I should make it nonfiction or not, because there's a lot of legalities that come into it, like especially when you're making documentaries.
Right.
Is there a lot of when you're making a documentary? Is there a lot of hurdles to jump over when you're interviewing and talking about real people in real situations? Is it a much harder thing to conquer than just making up your own story like in the web series?
I mean, you know, you kind of like summed it up in a nutshell, because the web series is actually loosely based on real stories that,
yeah,
you know, I've heard.
Right, from, you gotta get your ideas, right, from somewhere.
You know, growing up in Flatbush, there's a lot of people who, you know, became millionaires doing certain things. So, but, you know, putting it in a documentary format, you have to get clearance and things like that, you know, because you're opening yourself up to more lawsuits, you know, that,
yeah,
way, if people are not with it. Of course, when we do our documentary, we plan on trying to get clearance from everyone, and even if we have to, like, visit people who are locked up and,
right,
tell them, you know, this is what we're going to do. We're going to put your story, you know, and we would like to get an interview. You know, I think that always goes
well. And as long as it benefits community, I don't see, you know, anybody having a problem with that, because hopefully if they decided to want to right their wrongs, whether they can or not. But,
right.
The fact is, I'm sure they want to, you know. So, yeah, that's awesome.
Absolutely.
That's super duper awesome.
So, I saw your name all over the credits of that. Like, you were like, he's
that was,
a dirt review. This,
no. That was, I
he ran the show.
I actually want to shout people out, because I could not have done it without, you know, a cast, and my friend Lucho, who He's an excellent camera guy. I've worked with him on a lot of projects. He came and bailed me out on many times, on many occasions, even though there was no money. So I have to shout him out. All the actors that participated, Jerio Gomez, Roberto Zuniga, Chanel Francis, Miss Bolo, Chris Casino, DJ 11.
I like his music. It's really cool. I heard about that guy.
I couldn't have done it without people's, you know, just agreeing to do it without a budget, you know. Yeah. So, but that at the end, yeah, that was just you know, a little fun and games. We try to
personally, yeah. I believed in it from the beginning. Yeah. When he called me and was like, "Yo, look, I need you to come over here. This is what we need to do." Blah blah blah. I said, "Well, I'm on the way." You know, I know, you know, his passion.
I'll tell you something funny. One time, I saw. Have you ever seen the Two Girls, One Cup?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, jeez.
I almost forgot about that one.
How does this come back? This is two guys, one couch.
No, listen. It's going to be full circle. Like, so, like, for once in my life, I was like, you know what? I want to try to make a funny parody video.
Right.
I want to try it. So I convinced my girlfriend at the time.
Oh, jeez.
I bought chocolate ice cream.
We'll use ice cream, I promise.
And I thought it'd be hysterical. For some reason, to re-imitate the entire thing with us pretending like it's just we're eating poop but it's chocolate ice cream. I had to be like, I was still in high, like, I had been like a freshman in college. I was, stupid ideas.
Does Nina previously know about
it? No, she doesn't. She has no idea. Hi, Nina! No idea. Hi, my current girlfriend. She has no idea. My ex at the time.
Yeah.
And like, so like, that was like, I remember just like, all right, like trying to be a director. For my, like, okay, well, let's film it like this. We're going to place the camera here. And, like, for some reason, this is what comes up in my mind. Where, like, it was an epic failure. But, like, I have the video. But, like, it was just such an epic failure. I had the same music, the same theme, and everything. And, like, I don't know. I just think it's funny that, like, you know, that was my attempt. What was this your first attempt? You were director, right?
Yeah, I was directing. It wasn't my first attempt. I worked on two short films prior to that. I worked on a film called Bunnies on Deck, which is about Backpage prostitutes.
Dope.
Oh, cool. That's
and
pretty
then,
cool.
So?
Then, yeah, and then I worked. And then, I worked then I worked on a comedy, which Chris Casino is also in. It's called Stick Up Chicks. Mm-hmm. That's the other clip that
What are you sticking up chicks?
No, it's a Stick Up Chicks. It's a comedy about a group of girls who decide to go on a robbing spree.
Oh, I thought you were sticking stuff up chicks.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, I had some experience, but, you know, my influence came from, like, you know, I worked as, you know, extra on a lot of sets, and I also worked, like, as a PA on a lot of big sets, and I'm like, God, I gotta do something like this. But, you know, the reality kind of hits you that they working with $1 million and you working with $0.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
How did you record it, if you don't mind me asking? Was it through phones?
It was actually through Canon. We used the Canon T4i.
Similar to that?
Yeah, Canon T4i, T5i. Since then, we've upgraded cameras. I've saved up money and bought new higher grade camera, so when we do season 2, the quality is going to be...
So is season 2 filmed yet?
We actually start filming season 2 in August.
Is there any place for like some white guys and one that looks like a cop?
Absolutely. I mean, there's a ton of white people in season 1. Charlie Crane, shout out. John Toon. We have a few white people in there.
That's cool. We went to that brush.
Brush?
Yeah, we went to that brush from... He was like, Lee West, that was supposed to be your spot, man. And one white person, the whole thing, the busboy came out of the back of the restaurant and found a dead dude on the ground.
Yeah.
Like 5 seconds. That was going to be your bit. Thanks, man. That was going to be my spot.
So now we get invited to this theater where it's the premiere of, you know, Brush.
Mm-hmm.
So now we go there and the entire, you know, theater is just all, you know, black people.
Uh-huh.
And it's me and him. And, like, he just goes around and he...
I don't...
He mingles, I don't like, notice, whatever, like, you know, like, I, you know, like, Not that I, you know, it's just, but I am completely white.
He's exponentially white.
So now he's going around, he's just like mingling, doing it up, and I'm like saying like, hi, how are you? Like, you know,
hello.
Like, you know.
He's shaking hands, I'm giving dabs. You know?
Giving dabs.
That's the difference.
And then I stood next to him, and then he's like, yo, you know, you gotta meet these people. I'm like, you don't realize that me standing next to you makes you exponentially whiter as well.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. He makes me look white. Like,
so I was just like, all right. It was pretty funny though. But like with the movie was cool. You know, everything was cool. It was nice. It was an awesome.
So experience. Chris, you're not married, Brad. What about yourself?
No, I'm not. Right now, I'm single.
All right, cool. We have a fun question that we like to ask a few of our guests that we love having a good time with. You guys obviously are a good time type of people. Are you familiar with the game called Smash, Marry, Kill?
No.
No.
All right. So you got, fuck one, marry one, and kill one.
And you have to choose.
Oh,
you have
to choose. My God. Fuck one, marry one, and kill one. Smash, as you know, we PG it up a little bit, you know. Smash, marry, kill. A hood rat, a valley girl, and a goth chick. We're all familiar with these three terms, correct? Uh-huh. In your own time, guys, go ahead and...
Yeah, I'll let Chris go.
Smash the hood chick.
I guess that's the
smash the hood rat.
The hood rat.
Mm-hmm.
Kill the valley girl.
Kill the valley girl!
And what's the other one?
Marry the goth?
Yeah.
You're gonna marry the... Goth chick? That's weird, bro.
Hey, you never know.
Yeah, everybody likes whatever they like, man. That's one thing I'm into, is whatever you're into is cool. But, all right. And then, Brad, go ahead. What's up?
I would probably say the hood. Smash the hood chick. Probably kill the goth chick and marry the
valley girl. Yeah. I can see you with a valley girl. You got a blonde chick with some fake titties and a dog and a little bag. You know, I can see you doing that, man. That's funny. Mine personally is, I'd smash with the goth because they like some freaky shit. I would shoot the valley girl in the face because I just can't listen to it talk. And I'd marry a hood rat because I like duchess.
Rats.
Oh, man.
You know them sweatpants that they roll down a little bit. You know, like yeah, whatever. Yeah. Everybody likes whatever they like, man. I'm telling you what. Let's see, where are we? All right, we got like one more question left.
So where do you see your careers going, both of you? Like, where do you see the future within this next?
What's your five-year goal?
5-year goal. Like, what do you got? What guys want to do?
We make short-term goals. We make short-term goals. They're easier to achieve, and then once you achieve one, then you get to the next one.
So what's your next short-term goal?
We're going to be adding on the iHeartRadio stations.
Awesome. Right. So they're going to be playing that song on iHeartRadio?
100%.
I can get on board with that 1,000%. I'd thumbs up that. Oh, wait, that's not that. That's Pandora, right? But whatever, I'll thumbs up it anyway.
Thumbs up Pandora, too. We have friends over there as well.
Awesome. iHeartRadio is huge.
Yeah.
iHeartRadio is great. I got that app on my phone.
Would you be at the music festival?
I'm going to every festival that iHeart has. We already are.
What is your next coming up event?
Webster Hall.
Webster Hall. Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. When is that?
That's the next one in New York, but we have events out of town, but the next New York show is August 16th.
So do you guys travel around together? Like,
Well, this is his manager, right?
Yeah, okay. So we travel.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
when the checks come, we go cash them.
That's a great trip to take, you know, to the bank.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
So it's going to be Webster Hall on August 16th.
Yeah.
What's the biggest crowd you've ever performed in front of?
Probably 30,000.
Yeah, you just said before 30,000.
Yeah, wow. That event was the biggest event we did. 30,000 people, and to see them vibe into the music and into the music.
It was to watch them enjoy what you do. Yeah. I mean, like, from what we do, and I mean, you guys are on a much broader scale, obviously. But when we, pack, comedy rooms get 100, 150 people, when those people are laughing and into what we're saying and doing, like, there's no high bigger than that.
That's
I cannot stuff. Imagine 30,000 people yes. enjoying what you created.
No, no, and being past that, more than them enjoying it, they singing the words to a record yeah.
They wore out.
They love it instantly as it comes on.
Yeah.
Love it.
Just like how I did.
Wow. Appreciate that speaking.
Yeah, yeah, I really
yeah, he was like, this is awesome. This is I'm like, this is cool. He fell right into it.
Yeah, I loved it. I thought it was awesome.
That's great.
We also gonna be completing the video for Beautiful Girl in Miami.
Right.
Shout out to the Budweiser girls.
Shout out all the Budweiser
girls. Budweiser girls. Yeah, they're gonna
and
be
shout out to Budweiser.
Shout out to Budweiser.
Period. <Good drink. laughs>
Yeah, they're gonna be in the video. The current video online is Hot Chick, so you know.
They video online out. Is called Hot Chicks. Yeah. When I start Googling shit that says Hot Chicks, I like what comes up.
Yeah.
gentlemen, we're just about out of time. Well, first let me ask you guys this. You travel a lot by car anytime or always in a plane or?
Car short distance, like we drove here.
You drove here, right? Yeah. You guys ever been involved in like a fender bender, a little accident?
Yeah.
Boom, right?
We don't want any of those.
You don't want any of those, but when they happen, you know, not only do you have the aggravation of the occurrence going on, the cops is everywhere, everything's going on, and then a day later or two, you got the insurance companies trying to tell you, oh, you got to go to this State Farm certified shop, or you got to go to this Geico certified shop, right? My friends at Schwertel's Auto Body in Islandia want you guys to know, you at home to know, everybody to know, it's your right as a consumer to go to any registered motor vehicle repair shop of your choosing. The guy up the block been changing your oil for the last 20 years, you feel comfortable handing him your money, as long as he got that green registered motor vehicle repair sign, you can go there. I recommend going to see my girlfriends, George Jr. Schwertel, 200 Blydenburg Road in Islandia. Tell him you heard about him on LeighAlity TV. I mean, yeah, you won't get a deal. It'll just make me look cool.
Where's the deal?
But that's what I recommend for honest, dependable service. And you will save some money, don't get me wrong. But with that being said, gentlemen, why don't you tell the people at home how to get a hold of you guys?
Yeah, y'all can find me on Instagram at I Am Chris Casino. Same thing with Twitter.
How do you spell casino? Because apparently we spell it differently.
Casino.
Like it's normally spelled.
Like the casino.
Like we're throwing the dice.
Do you guys gamble with them?
I draw the dice.
Yeah. Ah, come on, man. I am the casino. So definitely y'all can find me at I Am
Chris. Put your money on black.
Follow me on Instagram at I Am Chris Casino. And link in to see what my life is like.
Absolutely, man. Brad?
You can find me on Instagram, Brad Busy Regime. Busy is spelled B-I-Z-Z-Y. I'm also on Facebook, Brad Busy. And, you can also find me on Twitter.
And follow my team, Chris Casino, at Team Chris Casino.
At Team Chris Casino. MrLeeWest.com.
Project9line.org. We help veterans reintegrate through art. Check that out. We have workshops, ceramic workshops, comedy workshops, songwriting, guitar, yoga, MMA, mixed martial arts, everything.
And Chinese food.
You also, have the veteranscomedyassault.org.
What are you guys doing tomorrow?
We're performing at Broadway Comedy Club tomorrow.
Make sure y'all come out.
Come check it out. It's going to be an awesome time.
$10? How much? It's $10.
Yeah, it's $10.
Show up. 53rd Street. It's a walk in. It's 8 blocks from the Penn Station. You go out there, you have a nice time. I've been there a million times. It's a great spot. Shout out to D.D. Martin and who else is out there?
I don't know. Shout out to us because we're producing it. All
right. Shout out to Project 9.
Thanks for having us, man.
Yo, Chris.
That was super dope.
You guys are awesome. Stick around. We'll take some pictures.
Definitely.
Thanks for coming. Definitely. Ladies and gentlemen, this is another episode of LeighAlity TV. Each and every Wednesday, strung on .tv. LeighAlity TV on YouTube. I finally got the name changed.
Oh, nice.
LeighAlity TV on YouTube. I'm Mr. Lee West. You can hashtag me. You can .com me. You just start typing it in and I pop up, I promise. I'll see you guys next week. I love you all. Thanks for tuning. Next time. Peace.